'Twas on the field of Antietam where many's a soldier fell, is where occurred the story which now to you I'll tell. The dead lay all around me, we all together lay, for we had had a fearful fight upon the field that day. And while I lay there musing upon the cold damp ground, my knapsack for a pillow, my blankets wrapped around, and while I lay there musing, I heard a bitter cry. It was, Lord Jesus, save me and take me home to die. He said I was the eldest brother just 3 years ago, when I left my home and kindred for the state of Ohio, not finding any other work to which I might apply, I bound myself apprentice, my fortune for to try. Well, I did not like my master, he did not use me well, so I fixed a resolution not long with him to dwell. And with this resolution from him I ran away, and I started then for New Orleans, and cursed be the day. Well, it was there I was conscripted and sent into the field, not having any other hope but I might die or yield. And so with many another boy I marched away that night, and this has been the 10th time that I've been in a fight. Well, I thought the boy who shot me had a familiar face, but in the battle's fury 'twas difficult to trace. I thought it was my brother Jay, if him I could but see, I'd kiss him and forgive him and lay me down to die. Well, I quickly ran unto him and heard his story o'er. It was my long-lost brother who lay weltering in his gore. I spoke of loved ones left behind and soothed his fevered brow. And he whispered, my dear brother, I can die happy now. Then quickly, like a slumbering babe, his fluttering eyelids closed. I watched him sink with shortening breath to death's long last repose. So with many's the tear and sad farewell, I scooped a narrow grave, and now he sleeps beneath the sod by Antietam's rippling waves.